The Philippine government shrugging off the threat of more transport strikes ahead of the April 30 PUV consolidation deadline. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Andrea Taguines. Andy?
Yes, Denise. The Department of Transportation has shrugged off threats of more protest actions ahead of the April 30 deadline for industry consolidation, which is required under the Public Utility Vehicle or PUV modernization program. This comes a day after transport groups Piston and Manibela concluded their two-day transport strike. The groups also said that they are planning more protests as the deadline nears. During a forum in Parañaque this morning, DOTR Undersecretary Andy Ortega downplayed the impact of the strike on the supply of public transport services, adding that the government already knows which areas to focus on during these instances. Ortega said the constant transport strikes have also helped the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, or LTFRB, pinpoint which routes still have low consolidation rates. LTFRB board member Mercy Lanes assured commuters the agency has also taken steps to ensure that there will still be enough PUVs to cater to them in these specific routes. Lanes added that the LTFRB will also be issuing special guidelines for routes where there are not enough PUV units in the first place. Lena said this is one adjustment they came up with during the span of the three-month extension of the consolidation deadline. That's in response to a statement by Senator Grace Fo asking what the government has done to address the apprehensions of jeepney operators and drivers.
Talagang napipinpoint na rin kung saan ang talagang problema or concern every time they go do Tigil's Pasada. So the service of the government to our commuters mas nagiging maganda.
Nag-identify na kami dun sa specific routes kung sino yung magpo-provide na consolidated entities. Naggawa na kami ng listahan ng mga existing nating cooperatives and corporations sa bawat ruta nakita natin na mas mababa yung consolidation niya. Sa analysis din natin, marami pala sa ating mga ruta ang number of authorized units ay isa, dalawa lang. So, napaka-imposible nga naman, di ba, na makapag-consolidate pa sila. May tinitignan tayong pag-handle na separate naman dito sa mga to.
Meanwhile, LTFRB Chairperson Chofilo Guadis III reiterated that those who fail to comply with the consolidation requirement by April 30 can no longer ply their route. Denise?
Thanks, Andy.
At least one person is dead after torrential rains battered the United Arab Emirates. Local media reported an elderly man died Tuesday morning when his vehicle was caught in the flash floods. The UAE witnessed record rainfall on Tuesday that damaged dozens of homes and businesses. The Dubai International Airport also faced significant flight disruptions due to the floods. The rains also killed 19 people in neighboring Oman.
Tens of thousands also displaced in Kazakhstan by massive floods. Authorities in the Central Asian country said evacuations continue in at least three regions. The deluge is caused by the swelling of a river in the country's border with Russia due to fast melting snow. In one city alone in the northern Kazakhstan, several districts were completely flooded with many houses submerged up to their roofs.
The Philippine Central Bank chief allays fears over the continued weakening of the peso. BSP Governor Eli Remolona spoke to reporters in a briefing Wednesday. He says the peso, much like other currencies in emerging markets, is reacting to tensions in the Middle East and to remarks of Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell on delaying their rate cuts this year. Remolona says the movements of the peso are still not enough to influence the BSP's monetary policy. The Philippine currency closed at 57.18-1 against the greenback today. This was its lowest performance since November 2022.
It's not a case of a weak peso, it's a case of a strong dollar. The magnitude of the adjustment of the peso has not been large enough to affect inflation expectations. So for now, I think the impact on monetary policy is, I would say, not large.